Hello guys, welcome back to Netcode-Hub channel. Now in this video we are going to talk about Ajax with ASP.NET MVC. So how do you use Ajax in ASP.NET MVC? So we are going to have an example for you to understand this. We're going to have a database table. Now this table, let's use student for example. We have student name, student gender and total marks. So you're going to use the Ajax to load a specific portion of a page, not the entire page. You're going to load a partial page, part of a page, okay? And as soon as you click on the button, we have the data being sent, a request is being sent to the database using the Ajax. So let's see how to implement that. So the first thing that you have to do here is I have a small note for us to read from. So we're going to have these three buttons. We're going to have all. As soon as I click on all, it's going to display all the data from database, okay? Now the next thing that I'm going to do here, I can select top 5 and bottom 5. So top 5 means the biggest, the highest numbers, 5. So in this case, I'm going to now arrange the database table in descending order using the total marks. Then I can just grab the top 5. The bottom 5 means I have to arrange it in ascending order because the bottom is the smallest. So for the smallest 5, I'm going to arrange them in ascending and grab the bottom 5. So that is the script to create a database table. So you see we are creating in ID, name, gender, and total marks. So here, we are going to insert sample data values. So when you check my database table, I have it over here. So you see I have ID, name, gender, and total marks over here. So this table that you are going to use. So if you haven't created that, you can actually pause the video and have it created. Create a table with this query. Now aside from that, make sure you populate, insert a sample value. So you're going to use insert into TBL student. Okay, then you pass in values. So with the values, you're going to pass in, the first one going to be the ID. So ID is going to be the identity. You're not going to provide the ID. Rather, it's going to be generated by the system. So name first. So pass in name. Then, aside from that, comma, you pass in what, gender. So gender, male. Then, comma, you pass in total marks. So let's say 450 or etc. So you can just run this and make multiple changes in it to have the database table being filled up with rows. Now, once you are done with that, you're going to add ado.net entity data model. Now, this is actually going to help us connect a database table to our application. So let's go to our project. Now, because I have a blank project here. Now, right click on the models and go to add new models or add new item. And now select ado.net entity data model. Okay, now let's give the model name as sample data model. So sample data model. Now that is the name. Now we're going to choose from database. So click on next. And now let's click on new connection to create a connection to a database. We're going to pass in a localhost server as dot, or we can put local in the quote, that's a bracket. So we can pass in either this, okay, then you pass in local, or we can just pass in only dots to get our database table. So now you can see we are selecting a database that is sample. We can test connection to see. All right, now let's click on next. So let's give it a name as sample DB contest. So that's the name of our connection. Let's click on next. Now this is going to retrieve the database table from the database. So let's click on the tables DBO, and now the table name is TBL students. So TBL students is over here. And now where do you want this to reside? In models. So let's click on models, folder name. Let's click on finish. So in this case, it's going to add a database table to our application. But in here, we have to make some few changes. Let's wait for it to finish, then make those changes. Now, whilst it is loaded now, let's change. So see here, we have TBL student. So let's click on that, and now let's change it to TBL. Let's change it, take up the TBL, so you want only student. Now let's save this. So once it's done, you're going to build this application. So you're going to build a solution to compile the class that you have created. So now it is done, go to solution. Now right click on solution and go to build solution. So let's build that. Now once it's been built, what's the next thing to do? So after creating this, you have to add a partial view. why are you adding the partial view? Now in the page, you want only a part of the page to be loaded, okay, or to be updated, to be refreshed. We don't want the full page to be refreshed. Since we want part of the page, that's why we are creating a partial view. So let's create that. How do you create a partial view? So we are going to create a folder in a view folder that I'm going to name it as shared. And now let's create a folder, a file in that and name it as student and that's called student. So click on Solution Explorer. Now click on views. So when you click on views, you're now having this shared folder. Click on right click on the views and add folder. Okay. And I name it as shared folder. If not, when you have folder already, then right click on that. Now let's go to add, then view. And now the name of the view is going to be underscore student. Okay. Now we don't want any model. So this is what we're going to do. Let's look at here. Now template, we're going to choose what list. Okay. We're going to choose template as list. And now with the model, we're not going to select any model at all. So let's see. So here, no model. Now with the template, we're going to choose list. Okay. Now no model class. So we can actually pass in the student model class here to generate other lists. But here we don't want to generate lists here. And now let's clear this as well. So, and now we are going to use this as what create as partial view. So we have the list and create as partial view. So let's click, let's use the model class here. That is going to be our student. Okay, so there's our student here. And now let's click on add and see. So once you have this selected, and everything's all right, so click on add. So this is going to generate the partial view for us. So let's wait for it to be generated. Now it is scaffold, as you can see. So in here, when you run this, we don't want to see this button because you're not actually going to create anything. So let's take off this page. And now you can see that this is returning an enumerable, meaning it is returning a list of students from this model student. Okay. Now we have name, gender, and total marks. That's going to be the header. And now when you come to the body, we have this. Now we don't want to generate this link. So let's take this link off. So we have this simple. Let's save that. What is the next thing to do once you're done with this? We're going to add a controller. So the controller name is going to be home controller. We're going to select an index, that is student CS class. And I have a sample in DB context already. And you're going to choose an empty MVC controller. Okay. So let's go to our project. Now right click on controller. So Solution Explorer. Right click on controllers and go to add new controller. And I'm going to choose what? Empty one. Okay. Click on add. And now with this add, we're going to make it as home. So click on add to just add a controller to our project. So you see we have a default one as index. Now once you have a controller created, what is the next thing to do? You're going to add a model because that's what you're going to be using. So let's add our models to the controller. So here you're going to use using system.models. So you're going to use system.models here. And see, it's supposed to be system, supposed to be a project name. So that's a project name. Dots, then we have models. Okay, so once you have this added, the next thing to do here is let's create the connection, that is sample db connection. Remember the sample db context that we created, that's a connection string. So let's create it on top here, let's define it here so we can actually use it in all of the action method. So we have it defined over here. Now the next thing to do here is we are going to create three methods. We have the index here. Now I'm going to create three methods. Now let's see with the three method. So this is the first one, and that's going to return all. So that's an all. So let's paste this here. So this means that when the page load, it's going to return index view. Okay. So this view is going to return this, and this view is going to be empty unless these buttons are clicked. So we have all. Now, what does this all mean? So we are creating a class of this student. Now, when you go to the model, you can see we have a student, a class, a model called student over here, and it is returning name, gender, and total marks, and index and ID as well. So we are returning that over here. So we put them here, then we are going to return the whole list of the students. We convert them to list. So that's all we are having all here. So since you're going to display it in the partial view, that's why we have to get a partial view result. Okay, so now here we are going to return it to a view. Now we're going to return it to a partial view that we created, and now a model. So this is a model. Okay, this is going to return the whole result. So we pass it over here. Now the next thing to do here is you're going to select top 5. So let's make top 5 and bottom 5. So let's paste this here. Now instead of bottom 3, let's make it bottom 5 and top 5. So now top 5, we are going to arrange the list in descending order from highest to biggest and grab the first top 5 over here. We convert them to list. So we're going to arrange them in numbers, so by total marks. And now here we're going to arrange it in ascending and pick the first 3. Because you know here we are talking about bottom. Bottom is the lowest. So bottom 5, we take the first 5 and now you pass them to the partial view. And that's all. So once you have this, save it. Now the next thing to do here is we have to add an index page. So let's add an index page, and with a template we're going to pass in empty without model. Okay, then I'm going to add our script files. So there's a index, right click and go to add view, and now you have index here. So empty without model. So now we're going to create as partial. So use this layout page. So click on add. Now we have it added over here. Okay, so whilst you have it added, what is the next thing to do? With this, you can pass in student. Okay, so student details as the header here. And in this, we can decide to use this as a page. Then you can pass in style is equal to display one. So display one. Then can just take this off and move this in between that here. Okay, now whilst you have this as a class, so supposed to be class equal to, now whilst you have this, the next thing to do here is let's go in there and now let's link our files there. So what are the files that you're going to be needed? So let's make it a student. Let's see. So let's go to the script. So click on script. Now first going to use jQuery. So drag and drop jQuery over there on top over here. Now we're going to need jQuery unobtrusive with Ajax. So check. If you're not having this, you can download it from the internet and now add it to the project. That is a simple thing to do. Okay. So now add it like this. So you have this two files and check the arrangement well. This is depending on jQuery, so jQuery must come first before this. Now, once you have that, the next thing to do here is we are going to create a 3 method with the action links, because you know we have to get 3 action links. So this is the first one. Let's copy this. We are using an Ajax action link. So this is the first one here. This is the first one. So we are creating at ajax.actionlink. We're passing the first one is the test. Second one is the action method. That is the all action method. Then you pass in new Ajax options. So the method here is get. The target that you want to display is the div container. We haven't created that, but we'll do that. And we have the insertion mode as what? Replace. It's going to replace everything in the container. Now let's see. Aside from doing this, let's grab the other ones as well. So you can see we have this. After that, you want to separate it with a span. That's the pipe symbol. So let's bring the pipe symbol here. Let's bring this pipe symbol. Okay, so you have this pipe symbol over there. Now the next thing to do here is, that's the top, the last part, bottom, 5. So you see that here, I'm not having the pipe symbol. So pipe symbol going to separate this and that, and this and that. That is a simple thing, okay. So what we can do here, we can put everything here in a div tag. So you can pass in a div. Okay, so here, let's cut this. And now you can actually paste the div here. Okay, so you have everything in a div tag. And this div, you can actually specify, modify it anyhow you want it to be modified. Okay, so let's see. Now, let's, with the last thing that I left here is a container. We have to create a div tag here. So let's see how to create that. So in here, this is what you're supposed to do. You're going to create just a div, and I pass in the ID. And this is going to display the list of the data from the database table being queried using the Ajax. So let's have a div over here. So that's the container that we have implemented over here. Okay, so let's save this. You know, these are the methods that you're supposed to be called, and these are the tests. So let's save this, and now let's run this Control plus F5. So let's run it and see how is it going to work with that. All right, so you see that it's now loaded, but you see we have semicolons over here. So let's go in there and clear them off. So here, now where is it? Okay, so we need not to bring this here. Let's clear the semicolons. Okay, so now let's save this. Now let's try to refresh and see if actually going to work. Fine, so it is. Now let's click on this button and see what's going to happen. So I click on the all, and let's see what's going to happen here. So as soon as I click on this, let's see. All right, so now let's see. So as soon as I click on all, I must have all the table. So I click on this, and you can see I have all the table, all the data here. Okay, let's now click on top five. Let's see what's going to happen. Top five. So I'm having the top five from 700, 650, and on the bottom five, I'm having 100 up to 650. So that is it for this video. Now we say that with the Ajax, we've able to implement this very nice and useful as well without refreshing the whole page, but I decided to refresh only this button. So we see that it is actually working very well, and we can actually grab it. All right, so that is it for this video. Thank you guys for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Hopefully, I'm going to see you in the next video.